Hey everyone, I wanted to cover a very specific recipe guide on the Telluriza for Nintendo Switch and PlayStation 4. That might seem a bit cumbersome at first glance, since the game does a very poor job explaining how to actually obtain it. But as it turns out, it's an integral endgame part that you need if you want to complete the whole game. I'm talking about the exploration points scattered all across the maps. Some of them are wind powered that will let you fly using whirlwinds into new areas, and the skipping stone exploration points where you jump over rocks scattered about the water to lead you into a new zone. Reaching these new areas will give you access to previously unreachable chests, landmarks, and bosses hidden away for endgame content, so getting to them as early as possible is kind of important. For this, you will need wind shoes, but thankfully you can make them around mid-game after you reach the Pin or Holy Tower your very first time. So how do you make these shoes, you might ask? It's actually quite simple. First, you want to make sure you get the Bestial Air recipe to make a few, and speed up the process by pressing the R button and selecting the low quality. I actually suggest making a few of them since you'll actually end up using them in the following recipes. At this point, we're going to go out into the field and do some quick gathering for items that we actually need, like the Delphi Rose and Trihorn. Thankfully, they're super easy to get. You want to go ahead and fast travel to the Lisi Valley and select the Valley Path. Once there, hug the right side and go through the small cubbyhole on the wall and harvest the flowers there with the axe. You'll get what you need. And while we're out in the field, let's go ahead and grab that Trihorn that we need. Fast travel to the Pin or Holy Tower and select the Sanctuary Garden. Walk straight to the tree right before the entrance and hit it with your bug net. You should be able to get one or several Trihorn beetles, since they'll come in handy later. Now that you have the Sorcery Rose, make sure to craft a few of them like you did with the Bestial Air. And finally, craft the alternative recipe, which are the Wind Shoes. This one's a pretty straight up recipe, so nothing special is needed. After that, you should be able to have your Wind Shoes ready to go. However, we're not done yet. They're actually not ready for you to jump through rocks or glide through the air just yet. And that's because you actually need two effects on them. The first one is called Lightweight, and this will let you jump across the stones in the water. And the second one is the Wind Rider, and that's the one that lets you use the wind exploration points. Since you already crafted the shoes, instead of crafting a brand new pair, what you want to do is choose the item rebuild option and work your way to the right of the recipe, using the Sorcery Roses for the lightweight effect, and then right after that, the Trihorn we farm back at the tower. He will give you access to the next bauble, which is the Wind Rider effect you actually want. Go ahead and round out the recipe, adding whatever else you need if you want to. Then after you're done, go into the options, gather tools, and equip it. The effects should clearly be listed as the lightweight effect and the Wind Rider. Now you're free to go out into the world and jump those rocks and glide through the air like you were always meant to. I hope you found this guide helpful, and if you're new to my channel, be sure to give a like and subscribe. And as always, thank you so much for watching. See ya!